seconds and I have some very little money in my hands. Some are black and some are white, and they ain't too proud to sleep on the floor tonight. The blind faith of Jesus, you know that they just might. Back in the USA.
I'm Mrs. Kerr, a fourth grade teacher here at C.E. Cole.
And Mr. Sola, fourth grade teacher as well.
Today is November 6th. It is a day four. Would you all please rise and stand to do the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. All right, now today, let's go to Mr. Payne for our weather.
Thanks, Mr. Sola and Mrs. Kerr. That was great. Hey, C.E. Cole, here's your weather for Friday and the weekend. We all have some wonderful weather in store for you. Today, it's going up to 70 degrees. And partly cloudy, but you're going to see a good amount of sunshine today. And this weekend, Saturday and Sunday are going to look exactly the same. There's going to be an abundant amount of sunshine, very little clouds, very clear all day. And both days are going to be in the low to mid 70s. And that sunshine is going to feel really warm throughout both those days. And then at night, every night, Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday night are going to be relatively clear and in the 40s. So get ready to enjoy a great weekend and make sure you get outside. Our question of the day comes from Elias Vasquez in Ms. Rubert's class. And he asked something that a lot of people have asked, Mr. Payne, how do they predict what's going to happen this winter? Is it going to be cold? Is there going to be a lot of snow? Well, yesterday I talked a little bit about radar and collecting all the data and using computer systems, and that is something that meteorologists do. But what has proven to be very reliable is the Old Farmer's Almanac, originally printed in 1792 by Robert Thomas. And the almanac has been recorded as being 80% accurate. That almanac is saying that we're going to have a very mild winter, not a whole lot of snow. The Northwest, where California, Washington, and Oregon are, they're going to be a very cold winter. Only time will tell. How do they come up with it? Well, they use a secret formula. Secret, like the Krusty Krab formula. Secret formula that involves tides, ocean tides, moon phases, planets, and sunspot activity. And this secret formula is locked away, and it's supposedly only one person knows what the formula is. And they don't use any computers whatsoever. In fact, this formula is so accurate that during World War II, Germans tried to steal this formula from the United States, and the FBI caught the person before he ended up getting away. Why would they want it? Well, it predicted the weather so accurately that they can make battle plans around the weather. Interesting fact. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Make sure you get outside.
Thank you for that, Mr. Payne. Mr. Sola, today is National Nachos Day.
National Nachos.
Nachos
awesome.
Day.
Love nachos.
And nachos were actually created in Mexico. What happened was there was a maitre d' at a restaurant. That's the person who greets you sometimes when you come into a restaurant. And it was closing. But there were some people from America that were visiting, and they asked the maitre d' if he could make a special snack for them. They used to go regularly. And he said, okay, I'll go see. But when he went into the kitchen, the cooking staff was pretty much done. But he noticed some toasted tostados. And so he said, I will cut them into triangles. And then he put some cheese on top and some jalapeno peppers, and he heated it up, and he served it to them. and the guests loved it. And so they said, what do you call this dish? And he said, well, I guess we'll call it Nacho's Surprise, because his name was Ignacio Nacho Anaya. And so he named it after himself. And so nachos were invented in Mexico.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
And last time we were together, I talked a little bit about the idiom blue moon because it was the second full moon of the month. I don't have any idioms about nachos, but I do have a couple of food-related idioms. So if you want to say that something is really easy to do, you can say it's a piece of cake.
Yeah.
And if you are very much alike your friend, then somebody might say, you two are two peas
in
a pod. See, he knows them too. And if you find that someone is really calm in a stressful situation, they might say, you are as
cool as a cucumber.
These are very common idioms. And if you remember, idioms are phrases that don't mean exactly what the words say. So those are three food-related idioms. Take some time and look up others. You'll find there are a lot of fun ones.
Very cool. That's awesome. Few things on November 6th on this date in history. 1869, Rutgers defeated Princeton in the first ever intercollegiate college football game, American football. Pretty neat. 1869. 1995, the Cleveland Browns announced that they were moving from Cleveland and going to Baltimore. They are now your Baltimore Ravens. Sure you've heard of them. They used to be from Cleveland. And in 2012, Barack Obama was re-elected for his second term as president on this date in 2012. Pretty cool. And I looked up some famous birthdays. Really cool one, James Naismith. He is the inventor of basketball. He was born on November 6th. Pretty neat. And here at CE Cole, it's the 311th day of the year 2020. That means we have 55 more to go. I know that math doesn't reach 365. It reaches 366 because this is a leap year. Okay, you can check the math, it works. And it is our 46th day of school here. This is the first day of the second quarter, boys and girls. So this is when you have to start thinking about, do I know what my expectations are for school? I've been here for 45 days. Am I prepared? Are you prepared right now for your day? You should know what you need to have out. You know that expectation, okay? And one more important thing, if you need help with anything, please, ask your teachers. Send them a chat in the Zoom meeting. Send them an email. Find a way to come to their office hours. Please, we have them for a reason. If you need help, come use your resource. Your best resources are your teachers. Please do it. And remember, as I always say, attitude is everything. Keep on smiling, boys and girls. Have a great day.
Have a great day, everyone.